Hey there, this is Daniel over at SPOTIO, and on today's feature spotlight video, we are going to be discussing territory management, which is the ability to obviously create and manage territories inside of SPOTIO. In today's video, we'll be discussing how you can create those territories, as well as how you can set up hierarchies with different territories in your account, and then how you can assign those territories to your different users, as well as the reporting and metrics for the different areas. So let's go ahead and get started. The first thing we're going to be doing today is discussing how you can create new territories inside of your SPOTIO account. So you do have to be logged in as an admin or a manager, and you do have to come into the map view inside of the web version of SPOTIO. And one piece of advice I always give is to turn off the satellite view inside of the map when creating territories. It just gives a lot more gray, monotone backdrop and makes it super easy to identify your different territory boundaries as well as the color coding you associate with those territories. So for today's example, I'm going to actually be creating several different territories here in New York City, and I'm going to start by going to the fourth icon down on this right sidebar for our territories panel. This is going to be where all of your territories will be displayed, as well as where you can hit the yellow add button to create a new territory. So for the first example here today, I'm going to start by creating a territory inside of Manhattan. So I'm going to divide up the different areas of downtown New York City and link them to a separate parent territory. So all I'm going to do to start is type in the name of my territory. You'll then notice we have three different options for creating boundaries. The first one is our most traditional method, and this is our draw territory option, and is about as straightforward as it can get. You basically just come in, use our little draw tool to manually draw out an area, and then once you complete your lines, it'll actually shade and create an area around the circled area that you've selected. In addition to the draw tool, we also have my favorite territory tool, which is our select method, and this allows you to click anywhere on the map and auto draw a territory around either the state, county, city, or zip code that you just clicked in. So you'll notice for this example here, if I select the zip code and hit add to territory, it actually adds that specific zip code to my territory, and you're able to repeat this process to basically add multiple areas into the same territory. So this is useful if you want to add together multiple zip codes or multiple cities into a single territory. And then finally, our last boundary method is our zip and postal code tool, and this basically allows you just to type in a zip code and it will auto draw an area around that zip code boundary. And just like the select tool, you can add in multiple zip codes and have them all put together in the same territory. So now that we've gone through the different boundary options, I wanted to go ahead and create a territory here around the Manhattan county line, or city line, I guess. So I'm going to go ahead and select Manhattan here. You'll notice it's been shaded in yellow, and I can also come in and customize that color coding to whatever options I would like. And then after I select that boundary and color code it, I'm going to come in and select one of my reps to be assigned to that territory. So very easy to do. You just select the option here for the rep you want to be assigned to it. And you are also able to assign multiple reps to the same territory. So just something to keep in mind there as you're creating your areas. So now that I've created Manhattan and assigned George to it, I'm going to zoom out a little bit and basically expedite the process here by fast forwarding and creating a different territory for each of the New York City boroughs. So now what I've done is I've created my five different sub-territories, and I'm going to now demonstrate how you can create a hierarchy inside of SPOTIO. So this is available for our business and our pro plans, and it basically allows you to come in. You're going to go through the same process you did to create your sub-territories, except this time you're going to create a larger territory that basically includes all of them in it. So in order to do this, I'm basically just going to call this one New York, and I'm going to use the select tool to come in and actually draw a territory around the entire state of New York. So you'll notice when I add this to my territory, it will shade that entire area, and I typically recommend shading these a more neutral color. So you'll notice here, I actually make it a light gray territory. It still is going to give you all of the reporting and the functionality of a parent territory, but now it allows you to basically see both the color of your sub-territories as well as this large gray parent territory that I've created over them. So after I've created my parent territory, SPOTIO is going to automatically identify the child territories that will be linked beneath it. So when I hit this create button, I get this nice little message here that just lets me know that all of my smaller territories that fall within this parent will be linked to it in our hierarchy. And you'll even notice now that each of my borough territories have the word New York below it, which lets me know that they have been linked to that parent. And if I come into this territory hierarchy screen, I can actually open up each of my hierarchies and see which territories are linked beneath them. So super straightforward, and again, a great tool for reporting. You know, if you're wanting to see how well you're doing in a larger area that consists of multiple smaller areas, this tool allows you to go in and do that. Another example I will demonstrate is you're actually able to replicate this process at as many levels as you want. So if I wanted to come in and let's say do the opposite of this, make a smaller territory inside of Manhattan, like I'm doing here for Harlem, you are able to come in and create smaller sub-territories within other territories, even if that one is already linked to a parent. So I kind of look at it as a trickle-down effect. You know, you can have a state on top of a zip code or a city, and then below that you can draw out a manual area like you can see I did here with Harlem and actually link that directly to the area above it. So that's basically the high level overview there of hierarchies. Again, great tool for linking and reporting purposes, being able to compare larger and smaller areas. So now that we've discussed creating territories, let's discuss how you can manage and edit them. You'll notice here in the territory panel, we have two different icons, one that shows you the total number of leads in each of your territories, and the other that shows you the total number of reps that are working leads in those territories. So I'm going to turn my leads on here. You'll notice you can see them falling now inside of Manhattan. And you can also see that I've assigned a rep to Manhattan, which I did in a previous example. We also have this little crosshair icon, and when you click on that, it'll actually auto-center the map to that particular territory, so it makes it super easy to snap to or look at any of the territories you've created inside of your account. And then finally, we have these settings gears next to each of your territory, which are going to open up some options that you can use to manage that territory. So the first one being this View Stats button that'll give you some very quick high-level stats for your territories. Things like leads created, breakdown of stage, and who owns that territory. We also have the ability to edit and remove territories with this settings gear. So removing them will obviously delete the territory, and the edit button is going to allow you to pull up that same territory creation screen that we had before. So this is helpful if you ever need to change a territory boundary, as well as if you need to swap who the current owner or rep assigned to that territory is. Again, it basically just pulls up that same page we were in before to create the territory and gives you full flexibility to editing and managing your territories going forward. So you'll notice here after I went in and swapped reps on this territory, I now have a new assigned user. And again, just a great tool for being able to manage who's currently assigned to a specific area. So now what I'm going to do is I'm going to go into my users panel. You'll notice that I have Elaine assigned to Manhattan. And this is basically another method for managing and editing your user access. So inside of each of your users, we have a territory access question. And you can select a user to either be global or limited. A global user will be able to see and manage leads in all territories inside of your account. And a limited user is limited or assigned to just that specific area. So you'll notice if I come in here to Kramer, for example, and switch him from global to limited, I'm now able to select a specific territory for him. So I'm going to assign him to the Bronx. When I put that in, you'll now notice that the Bronx is coming up as his assigned territory. So something to note about this is if you do have a user selected as global inside of this menu, they will not appear as an option to be assigned to a territory. Once again, since a user is set to global, has the ability to see all territories, there's no need to assign them to a specific one because they're basically already assigned to every territory in your account. So for this example, I'm going to assign Newman, Kramer, George, and Elaine to different sub-territories, and then I'm going to come in, and since Jerry is the manager inside of this account, I'm going to select him as a limited user to the New York parent territory. So this is a useful use case for teams that have managers that basically manage a larger area and then have reps working smaller areas below that. So you can now see that Jerry is now going to have full access to the entire state of New York, while his reps beneath him are going to just work in their smaller boroughs that we've assigned them to within that parent territory. So now I'm going to come back into the map view, and we're going to look at the different leads that are appearing inside of our territories. So this is actually where I wanted to start with our reporting run through. Basically, you'll notice, like I mentioned before, we have the ability to see how many leads are in each of the territories, as well as how many users are assigned to those territories. So now that we've created these different areas, we're actually able to leverage those as a filtering option inside of all areas of Spotio. So if I come into the pipeline view here, you'll notice that I can click on this territory option, and I'll be able to see all of those different territories, including parents that I've created. So this is very helpful if you want to, you know, take a quick look at your pipeline for all of New York, or maybe I want to generate a quick list here of just my leads that I have in Manhattan. I mean, pretty much endless options as far as being able to leverage those different territories to show you certain types of leads as a filter. And you are also able to stack multiple filters together. So in this example, I'm looking at Manhattan and Staten Island side by side. Again, I get a nice little breakdown, the total number of leads in each of those. And once again, this pipeline is now just displaying those two leads. We also have the ability to do all of those same filters inside of the dashboard section. So if you're ever looking at a specific dashboard or a report and you want to break it down by just a specific territory, you'll notice here I can select Manhattan, and it's now just showing me my performance and my dashboard for the Manhattan leads in my account. And then finally, several of our reports actually have territory options built into them. So you'll notice if I come into a report like leads created, I can actually break down all of my metrics by territories in this particular view. So I can compare, you know, all of my different territories side by side. We have several reports that look at territories over time, so you can see how well different territories are doing compared to others at specific times of the day. And then finally, our visits report has all of the same options where you can go in and break down your different reports. Again, all by territory comparisons to one another. So super useful tool, again, to come in and basically break down any of the dashboards by territories to allow you to compare different areas to one another. And that's pretty much everything I have for today, guys, for territory management. Once again, this has been a Spotio feature spotlight presentation. Please be on the lookout for additional videos in the near future. And as always, if you have any questions or need any assistance with your territory management, please feel free to reach out to our support team or our CX team.